Okay, bet. I just made your girl a sketch. She rep the set. You make my dick a wreck. Kill my new next. Disrespect the set. Now grab your head.
Hi, Danny here from Danny & Co Barbers. How is everyone? And welcome to my social media video. Over the last 6 years, I built up a wealth of knowledge. Owning two barber shops, a women's hair salon in partnership with Sassoon's, as well being a Wall UK digital influencer and a champion for Get Squire booking management. Over the last 6 years, I've learned an incredible amount of knowledge regarding social media. So within this video, I'm going to try and give you a little few tips and tricks to help you along the way. So we're going to jump straight in, and probably one of the main social media platforms that I use is Instagram. Instagram is a free business tool. It helps you to be able to promote your business. And yeah, it significantly helped me along the way. It's fantastic for being able to expose yourself and your work, no matter what industry you're in, whether you're a chef, whether you are wrapping cars, whether you are a PT, barber, hairdresser, the power of social media can be phenomenal. Years ago, you only got your work seen by word of mouth, flyers, maybe a website, advertising, which could be extremely expensive. But these days, you can just do it with a camera, a little bit of editing software, and you're away. We're going to touch up on branding. Branding is a key thing, sticking to a theme. Try and be as original as you can. Obviously, I started off with Danny & Co Barbers 6 years ago. I had a really good graphic designer, Luke Greaves, that I work with, who created me a brilliant logo. And he's been significant, really, into how well I've been able to present myself as a company. And yeah, having a logo, making it look quite streamlined, there's not too much going on, it's just clean and it's simple, that helps a lot. It can be quite distinctive to helping you stand out. The new salon that we've opened, Best Kept Secret, if you look at the Instagram page for it, which is Best Kept Hair, we've gone completely different with our branding than just your typical pictures. We've done a puzzle grid, which incorporates pictures into it, and we've had loads of feedback of how well it looks, and it stands out significantly. The best piece of advice I can give you is just to look for inspiration, look what works, look what's cool, and then try and come up with your own concept. You can create your own logos. There's enough apps, there's enough software to be able to do it. YouTube can help you significantly regarding branding. Stick to the same theme, don't be contradictory. Know what your USP target audience is and market it towards that. If you know your target audience is females wanting to get fit, then don't be trying to market it towards the over 60s or using color schemes which are aimed at kids. Just try to be as streamlined and keep in your ideas box as much as possible. It's helped me loads. It's helped me to be able to stand out. Yes, I've had a few bumpy ups and downs in my career. I had a void of probably about 2.5 years where I didn't really do much career-wise, and just came to a bit of a standstill. At the minute, I've completely been pushing myself and I've just been going from strength to strength. So regarding social media and some of the things that I use, I have a Sony A7R Mark III camera. I have a variety of lenses, and probably the best piece of advice I can give you is you don't have to buy it all brand new. You can get it off eBay, you can get it off Facebook Marketplace. I've got some absolute bargains over the years Got an iPad Pro secondhand from CEX in Manchester, which was a fraction of the price of what Apple was charging, and it was immaculate condition. You know, it can get really expensive buying things to create digital content, but you know, you can use your camera, phone, you can use a compact camera like I have here. I've recently just filmed a video which was a bit of a parody to the UK barbering industry with you know, me shaving my head, and you know, it went terribly wrong. I filmed it all on this camera, which is a compact camera. It films in 4K, and it just shows you don't really need a big expensive high-end camera. It has an aperture of 1.4, meaning how much the background is blurred out. This is a Sony RX100 Mark V. This is a brilliant camera. You can probably pick it up for secondhand about £200-300, and brand new about £6. Yeah, it's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. And the thing is, when you're buying a camera or a laptop or anything like that, it's an investment. Yes, it does seem like a lot of money at first, but you've got to look at it as it's something that's going to help you create more money. And then if you get picked up by a company and you start getting monthly retainers, or they pay you per project, then it's all paid off and it's all worth it. You know, if you're a PT and you get snapped up by a protein company, or, you know, a health food supplement company, you know, your quid's in. So all this helps. And what I kind of figured out very early on in my career, and again, not that long ago, is that if I hired photographers, if I hired videographers, they get extremely expensive. You know, a decent photographer can cost you a few hundred quid. I've known videographers charge £400, £500, £600, £700 for projects. So I just kind of thought, I don't have this type of money to keep wasting. And I went and bought the equipment myself and just learned on YouTube how to be able to create the content. And the key thing I would say in creating content is just making it stand out, just making it pop. And that comes down to, a lot of the time, color grading. Color grading footage and making the colors really stand out. So you would do that with editing software. So for photography editing software, I use Capture One. And videography, I use something called LumaFusion, which is for iPhone and iPad. And I also use Apple's Final Cut Pro. I've chose that over Adobe Premiere Pro because there was that many features on Adobe, which may be more superior, but it just looked like a very steep learning curve. I just wanted to be able to create digital content, edit it, you know, within about 45 minutes, and then be able to publish it. I didn't want to be sat at a computer for 2, 3, 4 days editing videos. I've recently created a video with my daughter in it for the coronavirus, and the whole video took me to edit about 1 hour and 20 minutes. You know, and that is something that is key to me, and it has to be you know, easy to use and user friendly. And I think Premiere Pro excuse me, was a huge learning curve. It's something that I might look into in the future. But yeah, Final Cut is what I use. Now, to make my images stand out and to make my videos pop, I color grade them and I use LUTs. So an example of a LUT is this. So as you can see, the LUTs are changing. There's different colors. You can grade it. So you can create more cinematic type look to your videos, and it just gives it an overall professional finish, which is, you know, something that you wanted to be aiming at, for just a really nice polished overall look. So yeah, that's the stuff that I use with my camera and some of the software that I use. And on my mobile phone, I have a few apps with the camera that I use, with the small camera. They all have Wi-Fi built in. So every time you take a picture, it will push the images straight to your camera roll just via Wi-Fi. So then I have Adobe's Lightroom Express I have on my phone, and I just play around with the colors, you know, the contrast, the sharpness. And again, that really helps towards creating some really nice finished looks, again, which makes your images pop out. And that is the key thing. You know, you have Instagram, you scroll through pictures and pictures and pictures, and there'll be the odd one or two that really makes you go, wow, that is cool. And if you think of people within our industry, you know, within the barbering industry and whatever job you do, there'll be other people like this. You know, certain people have their own certain looks. So, you know, if you know who Josh LaMonica is, if you know who Ryan Cullen is, if you know who Luke Dolan is, if you know who Colin from Hardgrind is, if you know who Tarek is, all these people have their own individual ways and looks that they do their pictures, their own styles that they do their haircuts. So you know instantly when you're scrolling through Instagram, oh yes, that's his work, or yes, that's his work. And that is something that you want to try and do. You want to try and stick to a theme. And you know, I hope I have my theme within Danny & Co. You know straight away if you see a picture and you go, wow, that looks cool. You can tell straight away who that is. So coming up with a theme and coming up with your own ways of taking pictures is down to color grading and having your own unique looks with overall images. You know, Kev Lutchman, you know straight away that it's his images. So, you know, just research, put notes in your phones, you know, you can screenshot pictures and just come up with what you think is cool. A lot of the time when I create digital content, I create digital content for me. So if it's a picture that I take, I do it for something that I would be interested in. If it's a funny video that I make, it's something that I would find funny. I don't try and guess what my custom base would find funny, because there's just too many. So I just stick it within my own mind of what I think I would like to see. And yeah, that helps a lot, because then people buy into that because it's your brand. I'm not trying to be Dave's brand or Chris's brand. I'm trying to be my own. And that's kind of what gives you a selling point and what makes you attractive to other big companies. And yeah, it's worked for me over the years. It's worked significantly, and I'm happy with that.